Just closed down a month ago.
Oh, no!
The place that I usually tell people when they ask, where do you play in Austin? The place I played all the time just closed down, so clearly I was not doing my job. or playing there enough, one of the two. But I played at a place called Strange Brew, but now I mostly play at a place called the Continental Club Gallery in Austin.
Oh, okay.
But there's other venues in town too. Play the Saxon Pub sometimes, or One-to-One Bar. Do y'all get down to Austin all that much?
Yes.
Only one.
You gotta go.
The rest of you should come. We have really good food and music too. Put you in my sights. For many years I watched you dancing in my crosshairs, but I couldn't pull the trigger for my life. But then one day I got the stones to take your hand, dear, and I want you with a flower and a smile. Though all I had to offer was a fireplace and a face you learned to love after a while. I'd never been away, and I returned home with a bandage on my forehead and a memory that gets weaker every day. And now you never touch me like you used to, and my injuries don't even start to heal. And I was sure right then and there that I would lose you. Oh, how wretched your beauty makes me feel. A trifle. I was surprised it lasted through the month of May. But now I am too old to lift my rifle, and you're still here to watch me waste away. My love, I've lost so many friends since we got married, and I know that you could say the same to me. I believe I was the first to ever catch you. Perhaps I should be the first to set you free. Saw you shining like the sunlight through the window, and the truth had started slowly sinking in. And I knew when I walked out the door this morning, I would never see your pretty face again. So don't go searching for my body in the cattails. Just be happy that I've found a place to rest. And by the time you read this letter, I'll be gone, dear. You know I love you, but this is for the best. You know I love you, but this is for the best. high school, I was lucky enough to have a girlfriend. And I also had a best friend who was a girl. And about my junior year, my best friend, who was a girl, became much closer friends with my girlfriend than she was with me. And I could no longer use her as a confidant because she would go and tell my girlfriend all the things I hadn't worked up the courage to tell my girlfriend yet. It's kind of a tricky situation, and it has absolutely nothing to do with this next song. I just thought I'd share because someone back then wanted to know a little more about me, and I thought, hey, it might as well be a good place to start. So now if anyone else would like to share an interesting tidbit from their own high school experience, I open up the floor. Perhaps you, sir. They're hiding now, but you told me you had some interesting stories, and I intend to collect. Perhaps later. As we make our meek adjustments, we never suspect that we don't understand, and we crumple up our passion in the palms of our hands, and we mass produce our fantasies to satisfy demands. And there is a place for people like us. What a respectable enemy you turned out to be. And here I thought you were just a bad friend, though none of us chose to be cruel. I suppose when we have to, we all learn to bend. When we trust in constellations, we proudly admit that we made a mistake, and we muster disappointment with everything we make. When the masquerade is over, we all put our faith in whatever makes a fragile thing feel safe. What a respectable enemy you turned out to be. And here I thought you were just a bad friend, though none of us chose to be cruel. I suppose when we have to, we all learn to bend.
July.
I'm 26.
Wow.
I got shirts on.
Me too. Somehow it works out that way. How do y'all feel about the banjo? Just kind of generally. Fairly positive. It's best to check a room, I've found.
Better than the accordion.
See, I love the accordion too. And actually, in college, spent a lot of time playing in a duo with me playing banjo and my best friend playing accordion. I found our music very pleasing, but perhaps we won't bring it to you. Let's see. There is one difficulty with the banjo, and that is, of course, that you must tune it. I did a tour last year opening for just an amazing artist that hopefully you've heard of, and if not, now you have. Her name is Sarah DeRose, and she's incredible. Yeah, clap for Sarah. Anyone that hasn't checked her out, she just won 2 Grammys. She's incredible, and she plays mandolin and clawhammer banjo and guitar, 100 other things. But she made this joke in the green room one night where because she switches between so many instruments, she has to tune a lot on stage, and that's just kind of part of it. And she said, I really hope that when I die, everything goes black and then I just see this timer, and that timer is all the time I ever spent tuning on stage in front of an audience, and I just get all of it back right then. Which I kind of think the audience should also get it back, maybe, but...
Anyway. So this might be a bit of a process, but we'll get there. In terms of the tuning, I mean.
I heard a rumor that the way to tune a banjo is with wire clippers.
Ah. Did everyone catch that? The best way to tune a banjo is with wire clippers. I'm sure we've all got a lot of these, and we might as well go through them all. I'll start, or I'll go second. This one's dark. What do you call a beautiful individual on a banjo player's arm? A tattoo. Who's next? Banjo jokes?
What about the lawyer? How long did you take to tune a banjo?
Say again?
How long did you take to tune a banjo? Nobody knows.
No one knows, yeah. Let's see.
What do a banjo player and an attorney have in common? Everyone's happier when the piece is told.
Yeah. I thought you were gonna say everyone's better off without him or something. Let's see. It's the difference between a banjo player and a large pizza. Large pizza can feed a family of 4.
What's the difference between a possum in the road and a banjo in the road?
Skid marks in front of the possum.
There you go.
Sorry.
My first banjo player told me if I wanted a sure thing in life, play the banjo, it will give me 2 sure things. I'll never be in tune, and I will never make any money. On that note. It's actually too soft for a banjo, I find. I'm going to turn it up ever so slightly.
No one gasped.
Corn in the crib won't turn your dollar green. Dollar won't get you high. Sometimes a drop is all a body needs. Sometimes the bottle drains dry. Pockets of change don't drive my worry down. Diamonds don't make me shine. It's a short life and a long time underground. I'll trade you money for wine. was no longer unsatisfied. Feared was my name in Elmore County, boys. Now they just walk on by. The banker, he spares a quarter for my cup. His travels deeper than mine. That way of life, boys, there ain't gold enough. I'll trade you money for wine.
Than it should be for a banjo. That was a Robbie Folk song. I'm going up and playing a bunch of shows in Madison, Wisconsin, which is Robbie Folk's country. He's another folk singer who was nominated for a Grammy and beaten by Sarah DeRose. But I figured if I were going to go and play shows in the Midwest, I should learn some songs from some Midwestern songwriters. Hence the Robbie Folks. This one's one of mine, not nearly so traditional.
Gentle as the ice. if you fall to pieces, will I be alright if you don't become the one I dream of? You can't let me go. There weren't enough art songs on the banjo.
So how long have you been writing?
I wrote my first song that I'm still so proud of when I was 4. It was about Godzilla and King Kong. And at first they fight and then they become friends. I don't know if that counts. I think I started when most people do in middle school, writing really, truly terrible poetry. Or song, like really, really bad pop punk songs that still get stuck in my head. When did you start writing?
That's a hard question.
Right?
Because I'm a court reporter. I'm going to say 1976.
Nice.
You were not born then.
Not quite. I just missed it.
Brilliant. Of course, we know who you are. Does it come naturally? My goodness.